is having a storybook season, unbeaten in conference, number two in the country, back-to-back 198s, and a win today gives them their first ever undisputed Pac-12 title. But Stanford can ruin all of it, and that's what makes this rivalry so much fun. It's the meet of the week, presented by Pacific Premier Bank. They call it the Big Meet, and it's only on the Pac-12 Network. California is enjoying its most talented roster ever. Over 50 years of women's gymnastics, they have three all-arounds in the top 20. MJ Frazier has already set the school record, 39.825. She's number four in the nation. Maya Lozon is number six, and Maddie Williams is the number 20 all-arounder in the country. Hi, everybody, and welcome to the farm. Jim Watts alongside former UCLA star Janae Onis. Well, you just heard me talking about Cal, singing their praises. It's all confetti and cannons for them right now. Where's the danger? Where's the threat?
I don't think there is a threat. You know, they've really proven their potential and shown their consistency. And last year at Nationals, they had some hiccups, but that showed that they can take it all the way. So now they have complete confidence and the ball's fully in their court.
Yeah, now they're walking the walk. They're setting history, it seems like, every week, and they can do it again today. Not only the Pac-12 championship, but they have a chance to go 198 for the third meet in a row. They've never done that as a franchise. In a Berkeley sky full of stars, well, the quasar, of course, is MJ Frazier. We already told you she's number four in the country in the all-around. She's gone 985 in 33 out of 36 routines.
She's really mastered efficiency on this team, a very dynamic athlete with the power and artistry, and has more skills than you can count. So she's still trying to find suitable routines in her second year, and she trains above the level she competes to keep her confident.
16 wins for her, second best on the club. For Stanford, they've increased their team total in three straight meets. The senior Chloe Widner is rolling. Wins on two events last week right here against UCLA.
She's a captain, very seasoned, and a pro at maxing out her routines because she never holds back. We only saw her on bars in the beginning of the season, which is why she's back on three events like she never left. She's phenomenal student, athlete, and person.
Golden Bears have won a share of the conference title the last 3 years, but they have never won it alone. Today, they have that chance. It's Cal and Stanford. It's the meet of the week, presented by Pacific Premier Bank. It's the Big Meet, and it's live on the Pac-12 Network. Spring in the South Bay. It is beautiful on campus in Stanford. That's the Hoover Tower, the tent pole in the middle of campus. Off in the background, inside iconic Maples Pavilion, where Stanford has been tough this year and coming off a pretty good meet last week against UCLA. But California has been ridiculous. They're number two, 6-0 in conference. They went 198-1 last week to beat Utah. That's the third best score all time. That was the week after beating UCLA at Pauley, going 198-4, the best score in school history. They're top six on everything. There are no weak spots. Everybody's healthy. They have four all-arounders in the top 35. You have to throw in Cesario as well. Stanford, that second best total of the season, came last week right here against UCLA, 196-725. And they're not just putting up good team scores, they're also winning events. Alex Ava was first on the beam. Widner tied for first on the bars and the floor. Stanford start values on the vault. Again, Olympic order, so Stanford begins at home on the vault. A couple of 995s and then four straight 10-0s. It's an opportunity for Stanford. Claire Dean will lead off three events. Little inconsistent on a vault. She could use a big score right here. She's gone over 9.8 twice this year. Her best at 9.825 against Washington.
Yurchenko full. Lacked a little bit of amplitude, so the judges will be taking off for that, but she did nail that landing, and her form is very clean in the air.
See her many times, and she's always in that leadoff spot. She's in beam and floor as well. Here's California Bars team, second best in the country, best in the Pac-12, averaging a 49.55. They have three gymnasts ranked in the top 12 in the nation on this event. Maya Lozon is first up. We've been talking about Maya Lozon all year, just a junior. We saw her get a 10 on beam at UCLA a couple of weeks ago, but she's great on everything. She's won on bars this year and gone 9.8 or better 8 times.
She absolutely is great on everything. She's a very strong bar swinger, very clean form. Strong strong connection right there. She just has the dismount to go. She's going to do a full twisting double back, and she landed with her legs locked out, but she held on to it.
Got as high as 995 this year, did that against Washington. Here's a look again at the dismount. Legs locked.
Legs. Ow. Oh, yeah. Didn't seem to bother her, though. She seems great.
We had a chance to talk to her after that 10, that big UCLA meet, both she and MJ Frazier. They understand what's going on. They understand how good they've been this year and the kind of history that they're writing on a weekly basis. 9775 for Dean. Amanda Zing, second up. Four times, Amanda's got 9-8 or better.
Another year she's a fool. She does get a good block off the horse.
There you go.
Nailed that landing again. A little closed in the hips, but that's going to be another good score.
So much of the focus today, of course, and for good reason, on California, a chance to win their first outright Pac-12. But Stanford can upend the whole apple cart if they have a great meet. Got to get off to a good start on vault. So far, so good.
Yeah, it's the block that really helped her get her chest up so she was in a good landing position. And I think her feet were already together. She didn't even have to get her heels together at all.
Statistically, the vault is Stanford's weakest, ranked 34th, only 7th in the conference, and they're averaging right on the 49 mark. Ella Cesario will be next up for Cal, but we're still waiting on a score. But it does give us a little time to talk about Ella, the junior from Illinois. Her first year as an all-arounder, she's gone 39-4-7-5, did that against UCLA, but so many other things happened. UCLA, the record high 198-4, the 210s by Frazier and Lazon. And so she just kind of got lost in that shuffle, but that is an excellent score, the 39-4-7-5 all-around. Anywhere else, Cesario would be one or two in the lineup. But at Cal, she's the fourth best all-arounder.
Huge straddle Jaeger, directly connected to a bail. And she's a taller gymnast, but she has such beautiful lines. I love watching her on this event. Great handstand right before her dismount. It's going to be a double layout. Nailed that landing also.
Cesario will be on the floor in the beam right in the middle of the line. Actually, she's in the three spot on just about everything. Two spot on bars. Some people are leadoffs, some are anchors, but of course most of them fall somewhere in the middle. With Brenner Null. And Tabitha Yim, the head coach, is right behind her. Final second instructions for Brenner Null. Hops out of the landing and holds on.
That is a 10.0 start value. But again, a very unique vault, twisting onto the table. But it's very clean in the air. It's really just the landing that she's got to hone in on.
Land on the heels?
Definitely. Yeah, definitely landed on the heels, and then she tried to just, you know, fight for that sex so she wouldn't take another, you know, step or hop. But I think it's good that, you know, Stanford, they're really building back their lineups because they have the rest of the lineup is 10.0 start values, which is great for them.
Well, you know, they started putting together 196 pluses. They have gone 196, 875 twice. They need a 197, I think, just to build their confidence for the postseason. Cesario, 9925 after the 9-9 by Lausanne. Andy Lee got the fist bumps from John Carney, the assistant coach, and is ready to go to work. Andy Lee, a three-time All-American on this event.
And she has the best straddle Jaeger I've ever seen. Just so much height above the bar. Floated down to that low bar for a pack salto and just really gorgeous, stunning form. Just gonna finish with a full pier to a double tuck.
What's wrong with that routine?
I didn't find much, but they are really locked in on all of these landings. That's three sticks in a row. As another look at her dismount, double tuck. Absorbed that landing, got those heels together. Exactly what the judges want to see, complete control.
She's got back-to-back season high 9.925s. This score's gotta be better than that.
Oh, absolutely. That was a really, really good routine.
Zane got that 9.875 off the 9.95 start value, then null, 9.775.
We're gonna see.
Ana Paula Gutierrez.
Yurchenko 1.5. She's the power, height, distance, very dynamic. Good on the landing. I think a little bit loose in the knees in the air, but again, she does start from a 10.0, so that already gives her a leg up on the score.
All six of her vaults prior to that one have been at least 9.8. She had a 9.95 at Oregon State to win the event. Up into the lights of Maples.
Yeah, she gets a great block off the horse. Legs are squeezed together, just a little bit loose in the knees.
Still waiting on the score for Andy Lee.
Yep.
And now it's at 9.95. So there you go. That's a season best for Lee. We kind of expected it. I didn't see much wrong with that at all. And just under her career best. And here comes MJ Frazier, the number four all-rounder in the country. On this event, she's ranked number 8. She's won 4 times, all 9 scores, at least 9.85.
And she really makes the uneven bars look effortless when she's up on there. Great Maloney to Pack Salto connection. She's gonna finish off with a double layout dismount. And she held on to that landing as well, so 4 for 4 so far.
You said it at the top. It's their confidence.
Yeah.
Last year, they thought they were good enough. This year, they know it.
They know it, and you can visibly see it, and just, they're not only consistent, but it's, you know, they're building each time and really honing in on those details that they need to. So it's just really, really cool to see.
I had a chance to talk to the coaches just before we went on air, and I said thank you to them because it's fun to watch this, to be around it.
Yeah.
See something special happening and happening for the first time in school history. 50 years.
Yeah.
It's neat to be around it. Good year is 9.875. And here comes Anna Roberts.
Another Yurchenko 1.5.
Back into the lineup against UCLA last week with a 9.825.
It's very clean in the air. She gets a great block and really floats in the air as well, but just, I love her form throughout the twist. Yeah, just impeccable form and just that significant step, but really everything else, I think that was just the main deduction on that. Her chest is up.
We've seen Stanford a couple of times in the past, only vault 5, take their score,
yep,
and move on.
And now they're putting up 6. And
yeah, Tara Lynn Wynn is still there. So nothing but 9 pluses so far for California. One of the judges gave Frazier a 10. Chanson with a 9.975. They're putting together another great rotation. Here's Maddie Williams, the number 20 all-arounder in the country. And on this event, she's a top 5 gymnast.
She's top 5 for a reason. Just exquisite form, beautiful technique. That was a good fight in that half pirouette to make sure she finishes in that vertical position. Another double layout. Landing locked in again.
Well, she's gone 9.975 twice this year. Obviously on both of those routines, one of the judges gave her a 10.
And that's why details are so important, you know.
9.8 for Roberts. That's what Stanford's looking for. Everything 9.8 or better, they want to drop one of those 9.775s. And that's where Wynn comes in.
A lot of power from this gymnast. You can go 1.5.
She's been a little up and down on the vault this year, but has gone 9.85 or better 4 times, including her last 4 coming in.
That was definitely one of the better ones. I think the main problem has been on her landing. You know, she is landing on an 8-incher, so it makes it a little tougher to find that good stick position, but that's just a hop, and I think that's going to be one of her better scores for sure, because everything else looks really great.
still waiting on a bar score. So score coming in for Maddie Williams, and then Casey Brown will be in the sixth spot. And right now, California's looking to drop a 9-9. By comparison, Stanford doesn't have a 9-9 in their vault lineup.
And that's exactly the scores you want to see in at Nationals. You're already at a 49-7, and you have one gymnast left to go.
So the 49-7 is just behind their season best, 49-7-2-5. The all-time score for Cal, a 49-8-2-5 against UCLA back in 2004.
I remember.
Which tied the NCAA record. We told you they're making history every week, maybe every rotation now.
That was a huge pack salto, so she came on a little high.
Yeah, she had to wait for it.
And so she's having a little couple breaks in her rhythm, but she did regain it on that Van Leeuwen. And a huge dismount.
So again, the score to beat would be Lausanne's leadoff 9-9. And then Cesario went 9-9-2-5. Lee 9-9-5. Frazier 9-9-7-5. Williams 9-9-5. Yeah, I saw John Carney before the meet. I said, wow, this is fun, isn't it? He just smiled at me. Sure is. Number two team in the country. Cal is on fire.
I competed, I think, about like three events for most meets my freshman year, and then I did all around last year, and I've been done all around this meet every year. So I think that like definitely has built my confidence just with having lots of practice competing all these years. So I don't really like try to like compare myself to other people. I really like just go out there and try to do my best for the team. I do like see things and I'm like, oh, like I am doing really well. Like, but also there's always a part of me that's like, oh, I could be doing better. Or, but like, yeah, I don't know. So that is definitely me, but I'm starting to believe those things a little bit more.
It's funny, she says she doesn't like to compare herself to other people. That's kind of what gymnastics is, literally. Yeah, and they judge you and score
it's
you.
It's such
on
a
it.
Subjective sport too, so you really are trying to cater to what the judges see or what they may perceive. And even talking to Liz, she always has to put on her judging cap too when they're putting together routines, because you don't know how the judges are going to take certain skills or how they're going to judge them. So that's why they workshop different routines throughout season, which is, I've just never heard a coach explain that to me, but that makes so much sense rather than just like putting a routine together and just hoping it sticks for the whole season. So
Casey Brown, 9-8-7-5. They end up dropping that score, which is a great score. In fact, it ties her season best. 49-7 is the second best bars rotation of the year, just behind the 49-7-2-5 at UCLA. And just a couple clicks behind the all-time greatest score in Cal history. Stanford went 49-1-7-5, their second best score of the season on vault.
Finding your healthy has never been easier. Start with Sprouts.
Old Trapper Beefs.
Oh,
one
go.
Upping.
I'm a big Old Trapper fan.
Not bigger than me. I love Old Trapper.
I love how tender it is.
Don't forget the wood smoke flavor.
What about the clear bag?
That shows you exactly what you're getting.
Savory beef.
Quality ingredients. I'm their biggest fan.
Old Trapper, what's your beef? The official beef jerky of the Pac-12.
Will you sign my bag and my tattoo?
Here's the scores for Stanford in that first rotation. They end up dropping Dean's 9-7-7-5. Lead off Zhang, by the way, the 9-8-7-5 by Zhang is not only a season high, that is a career high for the senior by far. And another 9-8-7-5 by Gutierrez. And for Gutierrez, She had gone 9.95 already this year, so it's not a season high. But how about Wynn in that sixth spot? That was kind of the weak link for them, as they only vaulted five, so right. They had to kind of take what they got. Now they have a chance to choose and drop.
And it's really cool to see now that they're able to put up a full six with 4.10 start values.
Just under a season best for Terrellyn Wynn as well. So now California moves over to the vault. They're ranked sixth. That is their lowest ranking on every event. They have 4.10 start values, just like Stanford. Williams will be in the leadoff spot. You see familiar names, Cesario, Frazier, Lazon, all the all-arounders. They've gone as high as 49.375. That's their average, 49.375. They had a 49.525 early in the season, which is the new Cal record, and Frazier had a 10. Both Frazier and Lazon ranked in the top 25 individually, and there's Justin Howell, the all-time winningest head coach in school history. He's taken the Bears to 11 straight regionals. That's every year since he took over for Dana Durant, who left and went to Georgia. And, you know, he came in kind of unassuming. He had been a club coach. He came in along with his wife, Liz Cradle Howell, of course, was a big name in the sport already. And they just did this slow burn, slowly just replacing everything and getting better. When they first came to California, these were their rankings on the events. Vault 47th, bars 41st, beam 44th, floor 58th. 4 years later, they were top 20 on all four events.
You said 4 years later?
4 years later.
And now they're all in this.
Now they're in the top six.
Six and up, yeah.
And they're the number two team in the country. Only Oklahoma's better. Oklahoma's won three of the last four national championships. Madeline Williams ready to go. And Maddie has Maya Lazon right next to her. But she's in her own world right now. On the vault this year, all eight of her vaults have been 9.8 or better. She tied a career-high 9.9 early in the season at Vegas. Had a 9.875 last week at home in the win over Utah. So Cal has beaten its two rivals in the conference, UCLA and Utah, back-to-back weeks. And then beating Stanford today would give them their very first Pac-12 championship undisputed.
She's a beautiful Yurchenko full, very clean, keeps her body straight throughout, really good distance as well, just that little hop.
Bears have shared the Pac-12 regular season championship the last 3 years in a row. Stanford on the bars, it's their best event in terms of rankings, 15th. The last couple of weeks, they have moved up an incredible 28 spots on this event, averaging almost a 49.3. They've gone 49 or better in seven straight. And Goodyear is in the leadoff.
She is superb on the uneven bars. Excellent form. Great straddle Jaeger directly connected into that bail. And she has a very unique dismount. You think she's gonna land a blind landing, but she's gonna do a double front with a half out.
Ah, very good. Yeah, you're right. I would have been fooled.
And she handles it so beautifully that you don't really see that much in college gymnastics. So she's got skills up her sleeve.
She's got 9.8 or better six times. Career high 9.925 against Washington. Look at this in the late twist.
Right. Just sneaks it in there. Toes squeezed together too. And just a little scooch to the side.
Yeah, but beautiful. Williams with that 9.95 start value got only a 9.775. It's disappointing. They want to drop that. Kyan Mayhew, 13 of her 14 scores overall this year have all been 9.8 or better. Most right here on the ball.
Was a Yurchenko full. She's capable of doing a 1.5, but they kept it out full this time. But great block off the horse. She gets a lot of height and a lot of distance. Good form in the air as well, and it's a little scooch back.
Freshman from Arizona. She announced herself to Golden Bear Nation in her collegiate debut at the Las Vegas Super 16. Got a 9.95 on her very first collegiate vault.
I mean, what a way to do it.
Gutierrez goes 9.9. Chance here for Stanford to start picking up some points early in the rotation. Ava Sorrento in a late change. Stanford tweaked their lineup about 20 minutes before the meet began. That happens a lot. Things depend on warm-ups. Sorrento salutes and goes to work. Sorrento, sophomore from Toronto. Don't pronounce the second T. She hasn't competed on bars in the last two, but she has gone 9-8 or better three times. Back in the lineup today.
Very fluid throughout this routine. She's going to finish off with a double layout. That was good. It's good to see her back.
Back in the landing. Had a 9.875 at the Denver Quad about a month ago. That's her career high. 9.825 for Mayhew. So the scores are pedestrian so far. Here comes Ella Cesario. Or did they change their lineup? That's MJ Frazier.
Yep. Looks like the line. Yep, so MJ is gonna be doing a Yurchenko double full. 10.0 start value. Very difficult. It's rare you see this in college gymnastics. And that was beautiful.
Frazier top 25 on this event. She has a victory. All nine scores are 9.8 or better. 9.925 is her best, so she has a chance for that here. Comes out with a big smile, lots of hugs.
And I just keep talking about how dynamic she is, but just look at how much block she gets off of the horse to be able to complete those double twists. This is very difficult. Only a handful of gymnasts do this, and I think with Jade Carey, she is not only doing a full, so she might be the only one doing a double full currently right now in the NCAA.
Back-to-back 9.9s for Stanford. Great start. Brennan Ault waits to go. We saw Nault in the first rotation with a 9.775 on vault. But she's better on this event. Solid. Four times she's gone 9.85. Tied her career high with a 9.925 at Utah.
Solid is always the word I use to describe Brenna on this event. Beautiful Maloney to Pac Salto. Great finish in vertical handstand on that half pirouette, and you just know what you're going to get with her. That's why she is just very dependable. Full pirouette to double tuck. It's a little hop on the landing, but that was really good, very clean, and should be another great score for Stanford.
She's going all around today for Stanford in the middle of both the beam and floor lineups. Vince Murrow, assistant coach here at Stanford, going over the routine with Brenna. SoCal has changed its order. Frazier goes 9.925. Maya Lazon. They need to prop this lineup at the back end. Lazon ranked fourth in the country on vault, six wins, has eight straight scores of 9.9 or better. Had a 9.975 at the Sprouts Farmers Market Quad early in the year.
Yurchenko, 1.5. Gorgeous form in the air, spectacular vault. It's got the height, the distance, just exceptional. And then the landing was great as well. Just look at that distance, and then just seeing her form throughout the entire twist is really, really great.
Yeah, California's lineup started with Maddie Williams, but the other five have all changed, at least in their order. You can see why they did that. 9.875 for Nault, so three excellent scores. Ira Alexeva now, the senior from Plano, Texas. On the bars, all seven have been at least 9.825.
Beautiful Higgins to Eagle Grip directly into her piked Jaeger, which is huge. She's a beautiful bar worker. So far, so good. Full pirouette, double tuck. Just holding onto the landing.
They're having a great rotation. best of the year, 49-4 at Arizona. That's in danger. They can get to that. Land softly and carry a big stick. Now we're into all the 10-0 start values. So Frazier 9-9-2-5, Lausanne 9-9. And now Silvers. Jaden Silvers, sophomore from Culver City, right in the middle of Los Angeles. In-season ad on this event. Three straight 9-8-7-5s. And maybe another.
Definitely another coming up. Great Yurchenko, 1.5. And she's very controlled, very clean in the air as well. Just a little form break on the table, but that landing was locked in. She opened up right at the perfect time. Yeah, so she split her legs a little bit, but was ready for that landing.
There's great chemistry on this team as well, and that happens when teams are winning. Everybody feels good. It's all hats and horns when everything's going well. Cal is 6-0 in conference. They're 13-3 on the season. They lost twice to Oklahoma, the number one team in the country. And they lost against number 8 Alabama, but that was the Super 16 in the opening meet. Alex Ava goes 9-9-2-5. That ties her season high. So Robertson Widner, they just need another 9-9 in here, these last two. And they're gonna have a fantastic rotation, maybe the best of the year. Roberts, this is her best event. All 8 of her scores, 9-8 or better, has gone 9-9-5 twice. Been back in the lineup the last two meets on 3 events.
It's been really great to see her back in the lineup as well. She has exquisite lines as well. Just look at her legs squeezed together throughout her bar routine.
Oh, has a break.
Unfortunately, her foot did come off.
Was it a grip? Did her grip slip?
I am not sure. I only saw her foot slip off, but maybe her grip did. Maybe she did lose her grip. Let's have another look.
I was watching her right hand here. It looks like.
No, she just didn't get her feet on the bar.
Right. She knew it right away. To rechalk, and then a remount. So remember, you can drop one of your scores. You only need 5. So it put a little extra pressure on Widner to come through for Stanford and rescue the rotation.
Chloe's most definitely able to do that. So she's going to repeat this skill. Does a Van Leeuwen. Beautiful handstand. She's going to do double layout dismount. Nailed that landing.
Arizona Roberts got a 9-8 on vault, should be back on floor in the final rotation. A little disappointed with that effort right there. Silver's 9-8-5. So they're already sitting on the 49-2-7-5 with Mayhew still to go. Mayhew has gone 9-8 or better 8 times.
Significant hop out, but good vault all around. She also opens up to prepare for that landing. She just has a lot of power. This is a gymnast where they've been working with her to get her to control her power and really harness it.
So the Owls tweaked the lineup. And that was late. That was after we had gone on the air. We had gotten the final rotation from them, and it was completely different. Most of the same names, all the same names, I believe.
Yeah, they just
moved the order.
Had the 10s go first. I was wondering why they had a 10 and then a 9-9-5-10 and then had the rest of the 10s. I was confused as to why they ordered it that way, but they changed it. So.
No score yet for Roberts, for Stanford on the bars, and then Chloe Widner waits to go, and she knows what's in front of her. They need a score now. They want to drop that 9-4. And for Chloe, it's her best event. All 8 scores have been 9-8 plus. She's got 9-9-5 twice. They need a score. Right now, their lowest score, if she comes through, would be a 9-8-7-5. Be a great rotation. Season best for Stanford. On the line right here.
huge Tkacha to start off her routine. And I just love how she's locked in on her handstands. Every single one.
She's got to finish it now.
Just has her dismount to go. Last handstand right on.
Moment of the meet for Stanford right here so far. Got it.
It was just a hop on that landing. I think that was the only deduction I saw. Every handstand was.
A dab in there?
You have to. You must. Pick it up after your teammate? Yes, absolutely. I would dab too.
So Chloe Widner, there's a reason she's in the anchor spot. Because she's money. Because she's a fifth year senior. We'll hear from her when we come back. Stanford, maybe their best rotation of the year.
I feel like I'm in a good place where I'm super glad I came back and I'm really excited, especially for like postseason and the last few meets this year. But I'm also kind of in a place where, you know, my body's starting to let me know, like, I'm done. I gotta start moving on with my life a little bit. So it's gonna be weird competing in Maples for the last time. I really like our home, like, arena. I think, I'm sure every team feels this way, but I love our equipment. I love our home crowd. Like, it's just, you know, it's just a little more, it means a little more than when you're competing away. So it'll definitely be weird knowing that this is my last time ever in Maples. I love my team. I love all the girls. And it's going to be weird leaving them, but that's definitely going to be the thing that I remember the most, is just going through this whole thing with them and kind of the memories and bonds that we've made throughout this time.
Janae, I'm listening to Chloe Widner, and I'm thinking that you must have gone through a lot of those same emotions walking away from those teammates at UCLA.
I was thinking the same thing, and I really resonate with what you said. You know, my body's letting me know that I'm done, because your body, you know, my body doesn't miss it, but I miss, you know, the team aspect and the family-oriented environment, and everything about it was just amazing and such, and I just love that she had that experience too.
Widner goes 9-9-2-5, so the score for Stanford, a 49-5-2-5, by far their best bars rotation of the year. So great start for Stanford. Stanford right now in the meet is sitting at 98-7. So they're on pace for a 197-4. They have not gone 197 yet. And they're coming up with their strongest event next, balance beam, and then we'll close on floor. So that's their advantage. Meantime, California. Mayhew got a 9.775 for a rotation of 49.275 for Cal. So that's below their average, but they're still on pace for a 197.95. So after two rotations, Stanford is leading by 0.27, or excuse me, Cal is leading by 0.275, but Stanford's staying right in it. And that was a big rotation for them. California goes to the floor. We come back where they are ranked fourth in the nation and best in the Pac-12. They're best on everything in the Pac-12.
Everybody,
your line score, 98.975 for California. Again, on pace for a 197.95. And that's after what would be for them a disappointing vault score. They average a 49.375. They can make that up quickly here on beam and floor, where they're ranked in the top four in the country on both events. Once again, the four all-arounders are all ranked. They can put up a big score here and get a third 198 in a row. Never done that as a program. And one more time, if they win today, California will be the undisputed regular season Pac-12 champion for the first time ever. Talking about 51 years of Cal gymnastics. Home team in the third rotation goes to the beam. Stanford, 19th in the country. 49.2 is their average. They've gone as high as 49.425, did that at Michigan. They have six straight scores of 49. By the way, the beam is dominated by Pac-12 schools. All eight Pac-12 schools are in the top 21 on this event.
On the balance beam?
On the balance beam. Claire Dean leads off, much like she did on vault, much like she will do on floor. Always a good beamer, five times. She's got 9.8 or better.
It's her confidence on this event that really makes her great for the leadoff position. She did have a wobble. She had to swing her arms to the side, but she tightened up her core to reset herself. That was a good fight. All that's left is her dismount. Round off 1.5.
So you have the balance check and then a step out of the landing, but other than that, pretty clean.
Yeah, very clean. It's been really cool to watch her progress from her freshman year to being in the all-around.
Sophomore from Piedmont, that's just across the bay, the Oakland Hills. Great neighborhood. And you're right, I had a quote here from Tabitha Yim, the head coach, developing quickly. Sandra Jessen, you saw there pumping her fists into the camera. She's out with an injury. Liz Crandall Howell. And you mentioned before, not only a great gymnast in her own right and now an excellent co-head coach at California, but she was a judge.
You can tell that's helped this team too.
She was a judge at 3 Olympic trials. That's how good a judge she was.
Oh, wow.
You know, part of their job, of course, is getting gymnasts to believe. You heard the quotes earlier from Maddie Williams. Liz Crandall Howell told our producer, Alan Brum, trying to get Maddie Williams to understand she's great, but she won't believe it yet. Maybe she needs to stay hungry.
Combination pass. Beautifully done. Throughout this whole routine.
Maddie Williams, currently number 20 in the country in the all-around. She's had 5 straight floor scores of 9.875. We'll see what they give her here. Claire Dean opens on beam with a 9.775. Here's Terrellyn Wynn. Remember, it was Wynn who threw up that 9.85 in the anchor spot on vault in the first rotation. Been scuffling a little bit on the beam. 3 times she's got 9.8.
Balance check on that series combination. Very difficult. A standing layout step out, back to back, 2 in a row.
Balance check there as well.
Yeah, quite a few balance checks throughout this routine.
Start to doubt yourself a little bit, try to be too perfect and step over there on the full turn.
That's when it's helpful. When what helps is just, you know, staying present and just taking it one skill at a time and not really thinking about what happened in the past.
Nailed
the dismount though.
Forever the great dismount.
Yeah.
Gotta be so aggravating. You're so close.
Yeah.
The smallest bobble on beam is so big. It's so magnified.
Right.
Speaking of great beamers, her head coach, Tabitha Yim, finished top 10 in the all-around. The NCAA's 4 years in a row for Stanford. And our regional all-around champion, Pac-12 balance beam champion. Back in the day, that was Pac-10. 9-9 for Matty Williams. Jordan Kane waiting for the green light. Jordan Kane comes in on fire on the floor. 8 straight at 9.85 or better.
I love her first pass. They were exploring with what they could have her do. It's very difficult. You don't see this. Or I've never seen this until she competed it. She's going to do a front pull to a Rudy. Lots of twisting.
Like throws her head back.
Really hit that 180 with the, which is exactly what the judges are looking for. Amplitude on that layout too, and I love that she leaps out of her pass too. Knocks it out the park.
Oh, I love it.
Here's another look at her first pass. She does a front full to a 1.5. It's called a Rudy, and I spoke with Liz, and she was saying that maybe we'll see a front full to a double twist. So that would be another really cool combination to see.
9-8 for Wynn. Sienna Robinson. Stanford's still in this meet. Down by 0.275 after two. And then striking distance, if you saw Arizona State and UCLA meet yesterday in Tempe, you know what I'm talking about. Arizona State was down by 0.55 after three. UCLA had a disastrous beam rotation. Arizona State came back to win the meet. Hannah Sharp's 9.925 on floor. Weird stuff happens.
This routine is beautiful so far. And speaking with the coaches, they said that Sienna has amazing work ethic.
It's kind of how you get to Stanford, isn't it?
You have to.
I didn't have that. She's got 9.8 or better 4 times on beam, and a 9.9 against Utah.
Love the moonwalk right before her dismount. Gonna do a round off 1.5. Got that landing. I love this, the male salute. Yes.
Own it. Bow and salute. Good for her. Nice moment. Remember that Dean had a 9.775, Wynn had a 9.8. This might be their best score.
Definitely absorb that landing and watch how she keeps her fingers together.
Feels so good to get off the beam, doesn't it?
It really does.
It's like when you finish finals. Still don't have a score in for Jordan Kane yet. For California, remember, she was pretty happy with it. And so were her teammates, so they're expecting a pretty good number. Kane's best on floor this year, 9.925. And she's done that a couple of times.
Yeah, they already got Sienna scoring, she got a 9.95.
Cesario would be third up for California. So when this happens, when the judges take extra, I'm just making sure that they're giving the right value to all of the skills.
Right. Yep.
Look at that, 9.95, so they did. They wanted to make sure they knew it was a good score, it was a great routine. That is a career best for the junior from Rhode Island, Jordan Kane. Oh, Cesario. First year in the floor lineup. All eight of her scores, 9.8 or better.
Great combination pass to start. Has complete control on those landings, and I just love the fun, energetic routine she has going here. Beautiful extension on those leaps.
So the thing I told people early in the year when we saw California at Washington was not the top talent at Cal. We knew that was there. It's deep in the lineup. They're good 6, 7, 8 on every
yes.
event.
Depth is really important, not only if you have athletes go in and out of the lineup, but just you can give athletes, especially the all-arounders that need rest, a break because it's a long season competing every weekend.
Look at Sienna Robinson, 9.95. By far a career high for the kid from Vegas. Great work. Stanford's having its best meet of the season. Of course they are. It's the big meet against Cal.
Triple series. She's gonna do a backhand spring layout step out.
Brenna Nault comes from Rancho Cucamonga. Her club coach, Jill Spaulding, I saw her this week down in Southern California. She told me to tell Brenna, when you're on the beam and you look at the end, imagine that your old coach, Jill, is standing there smiling back at you. Full turn, flawless.
I also love how expressive she is on the balance beam, too. Usually they keep a stoic face, but you can tell she genuinely enjoys to be up there. Dismount.
Got it.
That was gorgeous.
Look at the face. And I'll tell you, down in Southern California, Jill and Trent Spaulding, who coached her in club, they're smiling, too. Spaulding's now at Wildfire Gymnastics in Orange County. That was a great moment. Sandra Jessen there with the big hug. Look at California on the floor. 9.9 for Williams, 9.95 for Kane, 9.95 for Cesario. And here comes Mayhew. Mayhew's last five floors have all been 9.875 plus. Come on.
Gorgeous combination pass, double front fold to a front pike. That's a skill with E difficulty.
Thank you.
fun. One and a half front full. Held on to that landing.
A little short, but that was it.
That's
great
gonna,
stuff.
Yeah, that's going to be another great score.
Now, they already have 3 9-9 pluses, and still Maya Lazon and MJ Frazier to come. And Frazier got a 10 on floor at UCLA a couple of weeks ago. Nault, 9.95 for Brenna Nault. That is fantastic. That ties a career best for Nault on the beam. Ira Alexeva now. She's gone 9.95 this year on the beam. Five times she's gone 9.85 or better. One of those 9.95s against UCLA. Last time out. Double wolf.
Right on. I love the beautiful artistry that she does to start off her routine before she even gets to her first skill. Next is her series, the clay. Just switch half to beat jump. Gainer from school off the side. That was good.
Oh, this beat's getting good. Everybody's sticking now.
Stanford's locked in.
Stanford hasn't gone 197 this year. They're well above that pace now. And remember, they close at home on floor. Another 9.9. So if you go 9.9 five times, you go 49.5. They're better than that already. And they have Lazon and Frazier. Lazon has gone 9.9 or better 15 times in a row on floor dating back to last year.
So solid.
13th in the country and has won four times this year on floor.
Watch this first pass. I just love how she goes straight up and down on that front right after her double front twist. Great control. Control on landings, leaps were on.
Is that 16 straight 9.9s for her?
It will most definitely be the 16th. I can guarantee that for sure.
So listen, the all-time best score for California on floor, a 49.7 at LSU. And they have a chance at it. Alexeva got 110. She ends up with a 9.975. That is a career best for Ira Alexeva. Stanford is having a ridiculous beam rotation right now. It's going to be a season best. If they can close it out here, it could be better than that.
Chloe is phenomenal on this event.
Score to drop the leadoff 9.775 by Dean.
A I think we explained that she was solid on the uneven bars, but she's also extremely solid on this event as well.
She returned to the lineup at Utah a couple of weeks ago and tied for first with a 9.975 at Huntsman Center.
She's just very bold and confident up there. You can see how each skill finishes with an exclamation point.
The cover there.
This mouth's going to be a back handspring gainer full off the side.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, that's going to be an all-timer for Stanford now. They have really upped their game today against their rivals from across the bay. We knew Stanford was capable of more all year long, and now we're seeing it. Speaking of which, Maya Lazon just got one perfect 10, a 9.975. They have a 49.675. I don't think I even need to tell you that that ties the season high. It is just below their all-time best. And here comes MJ Frazier, who has a 10 on floor this month.
Double layout to start off. Stunning leaps. Really exceeding past that 180 that the judges are looking for.
So she did all that while the other side of Maples was going crazy. So while we wait for the score for MJ, Stanford was celebrating because Chloe Widner just got a 10 on beam.
And the crowd erupted.
They end up with a 49.675, by far a season high, but it's not an all-time high. It's in the top three all-time at Stanford. So today Stanford has its best rotations on beam and bars and its second best rotation on vault. That's of the season. They have really brought it. A 49.675 is ridiculous. Still waiting on the score for Frazier on floor.
9.975, one judge gave her a 10.
So the 9.975 for Frazier. Another all-timer for Cal on floor.
I'm happy. Like, I know one of the biggest things that I try really hard to do is just do what I do in gym and translate that to competition. And I think, like, I'm just letting my body kind of just let it just do its thing and just kind of just easing into everything, but like not doing too much, not doing less, but just doing like my usual. And it's a really good feeling to finally like put together things that you know you can do, but at the same time you're like still hungry for more. I did so well at UCLA and I'm still like, dang, like, I could have done so much better. And it's just so funny because I'm like, I guess people could say I'm just not happy with, I always want more. Nothing's good enough for me. But in reality, it's just like, I have like really high expectations for myself. And I just like, I'm really trying to reach those expectations, but
at the same time, I'm just trying to be myself so that when I hit those expectations, I'm like, oh, okay, cool. Like, what can I do next?
We were there when she went 39.825 at UCLA. I mean, it was a vintage performance. It was nearly perfect. That's only happened one time in the history of collegiate gymnastics where somebody got 4.10s, and it was back in the dark ages. Look what they just did on floor. So after all those early 9.9s, they close out with 9.975s by Lazon and Frazier. A 49.750 by Cal on floor is the best score on that event in 51 years of Cal Gymnastics.
That was really fun to watch, them going back to back with the 9.95s and then 9.975s and then the 10. Just so, so cool just to see each team really reaching their peak.
They dropped to 9. And then on the other side of the room, Stanford, Widner closes with a 10. It's the first 10 for Stanford since April 20th. of 2018 when Elizabeth Price did it on bars. It's the first beam 10 since February 20th of 2004. And Stanford goes 49.675, by far their best rotation of the year and top three all time in Stanford history. That's why they call it the big meet. Now, there's been history going on all over the Pac-12 this weekend. Utah went down to Arizona and put up its biggest score ever in Tucson, 197.875, and Grace McCallum was perfect on the bars. Oregon State and Jade Carey, 197.225, as Carey goes 39.4 in the all-around. And Arizona State pulls the late upset as they fall apart on the beam, the last three beams for UCLA. They had the meet in their pocket, but of course they have a lot of people out on Olympic deferrals. They have some injuries. No excuses, don't take anything away from the Gym Devils of ASU, 196.625. They beat the Bruins. Hannah Scharf, the senior, 9.925 on floor to win it in the last routine, in the last rotation against the Bruins. It was a sweet moment. We were there for it yesterday at Desert Financial Arena. Remember that everybody's getting together in less than 2 weeks now, March 23rd, at the Maverick Center in West Valley City, Utah. Pac-12 Women's Gymnastics Championships. And Janae, it'll be your first one.
It'll be my first one. I'm so excited.
Pack a sandwich because you're in that arena for 10 hours.
Woo!
It's fun. You got the four teams in the morning that finish 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th in the regular season. And then at night, 1, 2, 3, and 4, which we assume will be California, Utah, UCLA, and then right now it's Oregon State, unless Arizona State can pass them. And that is, it's the best day of the year. We always say longest day of the year, best day of the year. If you love gymnastics, it's Disneyland. You see the best all in one place on a podium. Everybody judged by the same people. So it's fair. It's wonderful.
I like that you compared it to Disneyland, the happiest place on earth.
California circles one more time as they go now to the beam to try and finish it off and go 198 again. This team, and we heard Maya Lazon say it earlier this year, that they understand what they're doing. Last year was all new to them. They're not cocky, they're confident. They say, we don't expect ourselves to be perfect, but we know we're capable of it. And the leadership, Justin Howell, Liz Crandall-Howell, John Carney, they're keeping everything in perspective because remember, what you do now is important, but it all points to the postseason. Pac-12s, regionals, and then you go after Oklahoma at the NCAA finals.
I like that you said perspective, because speaking with Liz, she talked about how they're not focused on outcomes and they're really just looking at what's possible for this team. And I think that takes a lot of pressure off for them to just do what they know how to do.
Cal needs a 49.3, 49.275 actually to hit 198. Their average is well above that on this
event. She was way off balance on that front aerial, so she...
Trouble from the outset. You don't expect it from Andy Lee. So that makes the plot a bit more interesting.
I was a little surprised she still went for it because she was way off to the side.
I uncharacteristic because the adjective that I have next to her name on my notes for Beam is reliable.
Yep.
But nobody's perfect on the beam.
Yep, this is a make or break event for any team, and it can happen to anyone.
Yeah, she didn't like it. She was disappointed while she was still on the beam.
So that's the one that they're going to want to drop. So now the next five have to hit.
Yeah, and that's the danger now, is that you know how it goes on beam. Somebody hits, everybody starts to feed off it. Somebody falls, people sometimes
tighten up.
Yeah, tighten up a little bit. Hopefully Cal just hits refresh and starts over. Stanford finishes on the floor, but they start once again with Claire Dean. It's her best event. 9-8 or better six times. Twice has gone 9-8, 7-5.
Great combination pass to start, and I love how she's worked really hard on her presentation in this routine. You can see it in her face expressions. Start.
All Stanford needs is a 48-6-2-5 on floor, more than likely to hit 197 for the first time this year.
That's the Claire Dean we needed to see.
So now it's up to Williams, Cesario, Frazier, Lazon, and Perea. This is Maddie Williams. Second up, starts with a double wolf.
Very speedy and right on the money.
She's ranked 28th in the country on this event. Seven times has gone 9-8-5 or better. Three times she's gone 9-9-5.
Beautiful connection right there. Coaches, they couldn't stop talking about how she just grinds so hard in the gym and always wants to do another turn, and I think that's what helps build your confidence when you're taking so many repetitive turns to really just lock it in. So when you're in a position like this where you have a fall, you know you're always going to hit, because she's really delivering right now.
There you go, that's one. They need to go 5 for 5. This is a great test for California and its character going towards the postseason, because they're going to find themselves in this position where things aren't going right from the beginning and they got to turn it around.
Right. That was a great routine.
And compounded by the fall by Lee. Had to come back and reset. Claire Dean, 9-8-7-5 on floor. That ties her season best. Amanda Zing. Three times Zing has gone 9-8-5 or better. Had a 9-9 at Washington. From our broadcast position, we have to look through the team to see her. and they're all mimicking all of her moves.
I mean, how can you not with a Mario-themed routine? Leaps to finish it off.
Well, when you watch someone on the floor and they're having fun, you forget you're in a competition. That's when it becomes a performance.
And I think that's the most important thing. You want to find the joy, even in the stressful situations, because that'll bring you through.
9.95 for Williams. Excellent reset on the beam. Ties a all-time best for Maddie Williams. Next up, Ella Cesario. They have to go 5 for 5. No room for error for California. Beam has been the biggest challenge for Cesario this year. Did have a 9.9 against Oregon State. 9.85 at UCLA on that big day when they went 198.4, all-time best team score.
Cool turn to start off, and I love watching her on balance beam because she's very precise in her movements, the dance elements, and also her skills. Gorgeous flick lay. She's on her heels a little bit on that leap combination, but she held it together well. Dismount, round off 1.5.
Look at the face.
There's nothing like sticking a dismount. It's no better feeling.
At the end of a sparkling routine on beam, that stick that landing, a look up. And your head coach, Liz Crandall Howell, looking right at you. Yep. You just did that.
Especially when you have to hit, it's a great feeling.
That's the only time Liz gets really excited. Then she goes right back down.
Gotta be calm rate. On beam, yeah.
She's a mom of, what, 3 boys? How does she stay calm?
Oh.
9.9 for Singh. Stanford is really challenging California today. This is by far the best Stanford team we've seen all year. Brennan Ault on floor for the Cardinal.
Double pike. Beautiful in the air and stays in.
She has a 9.9 this year. She's gone over 9.8 6 times.
Gorgeous leap combination. That was a switch leap to a torsade half ring, really showing off her flexibility.
Gotta love the Bond theme.
Expression on balance beam, and I love that she brings it to floor. Last combination pass. Beautiful control on that landing.
finishing off a very successful day for Brennan Ault. She had a 9.775 on vault, a 9.875 on pars, a 9.95 on beam, and expecting another high score here on floor. Her season best all around is a 39.325 against Washington. California comes back with Williams 9.95, Cesario 9.95, MJ Frazier, Maya Lazan, Gabby Perea. California could do something special once again today. Put up a huge score, go 198 three times in a row for their first time ever, and win their first outright Pac-12 title.
I love the deep breath she took before mounting the beam.
She's number six in the country on this event, three wins, seven times, 9.9 or better. Had a 10 earlier this year.
Great series. Remember, she talked earlier about how she's always looking to improve due to her high expectations.
Forget those. Little bit of a tilt, but other than that, got her head way back, heels up, almost touching the ponytail.
Yep. A way to show off that flexibility.
She's just fabulous to watch.
Cartwheel, 1.5. Yes. Landing locked in.
Come on. Well, you said it earlier this year when we were doing a count meet. You were talking about the gym slam, getting a 10 on all four events, and you brought her name up and said, I don't even think I'd be surprised if she got it.
No, I wouldn't be surprised. She's definitely able to do so. And you talked about reliability, and she's also another gymnast that's very reliable.
That's four 10s, one on each event in your career. She has 10s already on beam and floor, and 9.975 on bars, and a 9.95 on vault, so she's close. Back and forth we go. Anna Roberts for Stanford. Having a spectacular year. Freshman year, she was really good on this event, but she'd been out with injuries, so this is her first floor this season. She was always 9.9 or better last year.
Short on that, but she held on to it.
Big skill at the end of your routine and the final tumbling pass, and she knows it that close.
I'm glad to see her back out there, though.
Yeah, she was great as a freshman, injured most of this year, now back into the lineup. Three straight 9.95s, Williams, Cesario, and Frazier. They hand the baton to Maya Lazan. Lazan on the beam. Pac-12 co-champion along with Jade Carey last year, ranked number four, four wins, and out of 10 at UCLA 2 weeks ago.
That mount is my favorite, the way she shows off her back flexibility. Triple series coming up. Two back handsprings into a layout step out. Perfectly centered. I just love seeing what she's done in her career thus far, because she came into a freshman not really knowing if she could push her gymnastics further, but each year she's gotten better and better, and we're finally seeing those results. Superb routine thus far, just the dismount, round off, double full.
Oh, they did it again.
Take another look at that dismount. She sticks the landing, but I never know what the judges would do if, you know, you get your heels together, but they don't touch because your feet are too wide. So we'll see.
They need one more. They need Gabby Perea in the anchor spot. But first we go back to the floor. Roberts got a 9.875 on floor for Stanford. So they're low score right now. The 9.875s and the score coming in for Cal, for Lazon.
Gave it to her. That routine was excellent.
Her second 10 of the season on beam. Can't even keep up with it. So many things are happening. This is Carolyn Wynn's best event. Five times, she's got 9.875 or better. A couple of 9.9s at Michigan and at Oregon State. And the floor is hers.
Lots of power from her. Double layout, huge tumbling pass. Drop.
I do love the mic drop. Yeah, this has been percolating for Stanford all year.
That's my favorite celebration.
This kind of performance, they just couldn't put a clean meet together with four rotations. The numbers were there. They've gone 196, 975 a couple of times. So they were threatening, and now they're blowing it out. Lazon, a 10, the third of her career, the second of the season. But they're not out of the woods yet. They need Gabby Perea to be clean, start to finish. Perea finished third at the Pac-12s on this event last year. Four times this season, she's gone 9.9 plus.
Front toss, back tap.
Locked in.
Control on her leaps is exceptional. She's really taking her time, being very patient up there. Dismount, side summy.
There it is.
And she stuck it.
How clutch is that? Gabby Perea says, put it to bed.
Yeah,
that's remarkable what Cal just did.
It's a very unique dismount. You have to workshop. Oh, she had a little scooch, but she nailed it. Did exactly what they needed her to do.
Right in the face of the judges, too, on that dismount. I didn't see any worry on Cal, even when they had to go 5 for 5. Terrellyn Wynn, 9-9-2-5. Great rotation. Stanford's already gone 49-5 on the floor. That's by far their best of the season. So all four of the rotations for Stanford, either best or second best of the season. And once again, Chloe Widner. She's been outstanding on floor, 9-8-5 or better 4 times.
Great routine to finish off this floor lineup for Stanford. And I just can't help but think about when I was speaking with Tabitha and how this is the team that they've been wanting to show you guys from the start. They've had a lot of obstacles and things thrown their way. And now we're seeing the card.
It's a perfect example of how both teams can win in a gymnastics meet. California just put up the all-time best score in school history. For 100 years, the best talent in the country has found its way to the campus at Stanford University. And today we see more of that inside Maples Pavilion, where California just put up the best score in school history, 198.55. But that's only part of the story, because Stanford had not gone 197 all year long and almost went 198. A 197.975 for Stanford. Chloe Widner joins us now, and she had an amazing day, including a 10 on the beam. Chloe, before we talk about you individually, let's talk about what it meant to Stanford. We knew you guys had this kind of performance all year long. Were you confident we'd see it?
Yes, I was. We have put in so much work over the summer, over the preseason, and, you know, this year we've been really focusing on ourselves, working really hard, and just waiting for it to all come together, and it finally did today.
And speaking with Tabitha, she explained how you trained to leave it out on the floor, and that helps with your confidence. Did you come in as a freshman like that, or did you learn that when you became an upperclassman?
That's definitely something that I had to grow into throughout my time here, but I think as a freshman, the team still had that mentality, and I've just individually gotten better at it throughout the time.
What about the 10? Did you know it was a 10?
Yeah, I had done a few routines that were, I feel like, that caliber before, so I was just kind of wondering if they were going to throw it. So I wasn't sure, but it was super exciting that they gave it.
We're looking back at it. I know you don't have a monitor. What do you remember from that beam?
I remember that everyone before me had been hitting, and, like, each time someone hit, I was like, all right, they're setting it up for me. Like, I have to do a good routine here because, like, this is my chance. And every single skill I did, I was like, okay, like, that was good. Let's do the next one, and I just kept going until the end.
We are nearing the end of the regular season. Postseason is just ahead. I think you have a try meet at Utah still to go before we go back to Salt Lake City for the Pac-12s. Listen, if somebody would have said to me, how good is Stanford? I would have said, they're 197.5. Are you good enough for a 198 now? Because that was pretty close.
Oh, yeah, we definitely are. We still have more to give, and we left a lot out on the floor today.
All right, so when you finish today and you go pick up your phone, who's the first person you're going to call and talk about that 10?
I would say my parents, but they're here today, so I'll get to see them in person and talk about
well,
it.
There you go. You don't even need to waste the airtime
right,
now. You can just
sure.
go talk to your parents. Listen, as a parent myself, I can only imagine how proud they are. Congratulations. Thank you for the time. That was awesome.
Thank you so much.
Chloe Winder with a 10. Chloe had a great day. Stanford had an amazing day. But what about California and the 198.55? Janae, a couple weeks ago at Pauley Pavilion, they took care of UCLA with a 198.4. That was the highest score in school history. Now they come and go 198.55 at Stanford.
Yeah,
I would think that the Howls should pay us to follow them around the country.
I would love to follow them around the country. And I've said it before, and I'll say it again, that they have shown and are continuing to show their potential, but they're consistent and they're improving every week. And even with that fault in the beginning of the beam lineup, they went lights out with those other five routines. And that just shows, you know, ice in their veins and that they can stand up to any adversity that is thrown their way.
Well, what they did on the beam after the opening fall was amazing. The four all-arounders today, Madeline Williams, 39.575. Ella Cesario, 39.65. Maya Lazant, 39.775. And MJ Frazier goes 39.825, tying her own school record again. California, Pac-12 champions alone for the first time ever. For Alan Brum, your producer, Tim Lay, your director, my partner, Janae Honest, and for Joel Farbstein, our statistician, I'm Jim Watson. So long from Maples, where we saw magic. California and Stanford, huge days in the big meet.